Hi, my name is Nora Twomey, and I directed the film My Father's Dragon. My Father's Dragon is the story of Elmer, and he's not quite yet in his teen years when he realizes that the people around him, especially the adults, don't really have the answers to anything. They don't have anything figured out, and that his life is getting really tough. And so his answer is to run away to a magical land called Wild Island in search of a dragon who he thinks is going to sort everything out for him, answer all his questions, and figure out his entire life and make everything okay again. Of course, the dragon turns out to be a kid just like Elmer. And so that's the basic premise of the film. And yeah. We had a wonderful opportunity with My Father's Dragon. Netflix came on board really early and they said, you know, as a filmmaker, we just want you to do your best work. And so I and a team of 300 people kind of got together to make this film. And I think that it's incredibly immersive. We really unleashed our imaginations and our childlike imaginations. In fact, I asked the children of my life, my two boys, to draw from the book and to try and imagine what the tigers looked like, what the dragon looked like, and that's the kind of approach that we took to this. We just wanted to take children's imaginations really seriously and imagine that we were children ourselves. And that's very much the approach that Ruth Stiles Gannett, who is the author of the book that the film is inspired by, she had that approach as well. She always took children's imaginations really seriously, and so that's the heart of the film. Well, we were really lucky with My Father's Dragon. Gaten, Matarazzo said yes to the part of Boris the Dragon, and Jacob Tremblay said yes to Elmer, you know. And their relationship is absolutely the heart of the film, is the central, most important dynamic. Amy Lippins, our casting director, just, you know, encouraged me to like shoot for the stars when we came to casting for this film. So we also have Whoopi Goldberg, we have Ian McShane, we have Rita Moreno, Diane Weiss. We've just such an incredible cast, but the very heart of it is Gaten and Jacob. And from the moment that they got together in that recording booth in the sound studio, I knew that my job as a director was going to be easy, because they already had a massive magic between them, kind of like a sibling almost relationship. They were just messing the entire time. So yeah, they're just incredible young performers, young actors. They're brilliant. You know, he went at My Father's Dragon and the character of Boris with his whole heart. You know, I think he identified with the character of the dragon a little bit. There was often times where, you know, we were going through lines and he didn't need much explanation, let's say, you know, in terms of understanding Boris. But he also is just, I think he's a writer and a filmmaker himself, in that the questions that he was asking about the plot and that, they were really sophisticated questions, even though he was 19 when he was recording for the part of Boris. And so yeah, he just brought something absolutely magic to the part, and his comic timing is brilliant, you know. And he can go from, you know, high comedy to, you know, really deep and meaningful and heartfelt emotion in the really short space of time. Is just incredible to witness as a director. We're all storytellers, you know. If we're lucky enough to go home in the evening and somebody asks you how was your day, you kind of tell a story about how your day was, you know, as you try and make sense of the world around you and your part in it and how you make meaning, you know, how you create meaning for yourself. And so to be able to, you know, be in a position where I can, you know, make films like this one with Netflix, and, you know, it's out on November 11th, everybody, you know, around the world, for me, that's a massive thing, like that anyone around the world could just choose to watch this film. I really do believe that films are like kind of, you know, aids, like our crutches that we can lean on when we need them. You know, we all look to stories to tell us that somebody else has been through this before, somebody else has, you know, had an experience before that they got through. And I think that we all look to our favorite stories when things get a little bit challenging, and we find comfort in them.